Evaluation goals for Mandar's speech. Would you let everybody know what that is?
All right. So Mandar is going to, I don't know what the topic is about, but he wants me and us to look for his vocal variety. So looking at vocal tone and things like that, making sure it's not completely flat the entire speech, and that he's injecting some vocal variety into what he's saying. So I'd like you guys to welcome Mandar and listen to his speech.
Respected fellow Toastmasters and honored guests, very good evening to one and all. Today I am going to talk about a topic which is very closely related to the pandemic which we have been facing over the past 1.5 years. Today I'll be talking about the deadliest epic plague in the history. The resources of this story is derived from a book called The Great Influenza by John M. Barry. John M. Barry is a world-renowned historian, and in his book, he grippingly talks about the deadliest pandemic which occurred due to the Great Influenza, which is often referred to as Spanish influenza or a flu. It was a time just after the First World War, when troops were returning from the war, and suddenly the Navy had experienced a lot of health related issues in the patients. Every day, people were experiencing symptoms like cough, cold, headache, and sometimes vomiting as well. So to tackle this issue, a renowned scientist named Paul Lewis was called upon, and he was really intrigued and threatened by this issue, because every day there was a geometrical progression in the increase of the cases, and no one was sure what this was all about. And at that time, he predicted that this was going to be a very large outbreak leading to a huge pandemic, and he was right. He was spot on in his prediction, because the great influenza which I am talking about was so deadly that it caused the deaths in a one year, which was as equivalent to what the deaths were caused by AIDS in almost 24 years. So this was a very, very critical phase, and especially United States in that situation was not as efficient as what it is now. So of course there were institutions and like John Hopkins University or the Rockefeller Institute in the New York, which were setting standards for stringent research in the field of medical science and life sciences, but they were still in the growing phase. One of the most prominent figures in those time, the author talks about, is William Henry Welch. William Welch was one of those catalysts in the evolution of the medical science in the U.S., who led a generation of scientists who were about to make significant contributions, not only to confront the great influenza, but also to tackle polio, typhoid, and diphtheria, and any other and major deadly outbreaks. But the case of great influenza was on another level. It had created so much panic and terror among the people that they required relentless experimentation and detailing in in labs and working upon samples to find what caused the outbreak. There were some renowned scientists like Oswald Avery, Rufus Cole, who was the head of the Rockefeller Institute, and many other people who dedicated their entire life on this to find a vaccination and cure for this deadly pandemic. So this book has inspired me a lot about what we can learn from the case study of the great influenza. And it surely tells about whether the people in that era could have handled it well, or any best practices that could have been implemented would have helped or not. So, for example, recently the director of National Institute of Diseases Control and the direct advisor to the president, Dr. Anthony Fauci, has recommended everyone to read this book, The Great Influenza. It is not because what havoc it created, but it was due to the learnings which we can get to tackle the pandemic which we are in. It brings up in the notice two major criteria about what we can do in handling any future pandemic. It says that whenever an authority is communicating the practices about any outbreak such as great influenza or COVID-19, one must be aware of communicating it well to the public. And that was a mistake which happened during the 1918 pandemic, which led to inappropriate communication to the public, and eventually led to the horror among people and terror due to the pandemic itself. People were so reluctant to help each other in those tough times. Even though the significant contributions from Red Cross and all these medical institutions were on the high, but there were a lot of inefficiencies which could have been better handled if the organizations had communicated the urgent issues well. So I would definitely recommend all of you to read this book and understand the complexities of outbreaks and take care of yourself. Thank you.
Thank you, Mandar. Once again, can we take 1 minute to provide some feedback to Mandar as our speaker that will help him continue to improve before our next section starts up?